فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
صار على نهجه وقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Today we're in the sharah of the kitab تحفة السنية في شرح مقدمة الأجرومية written by محمد محي الدين عبد الحميد رحمه الله. We previously spoke about the eight things which we do إعراب of. And today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to start with the first of alamatul i'rab. The alamatul i'rab, the author mentions, how much are they? They're four. The alamatul i'rab are what? Four. The first one of them is al-raf'u, wal-nasbu, wal-khafdu, al-jar. And last but not least, al-jazm. Those are the four alamat of i'rab. Today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to do the first of them, which is al-raf'u. So today's class is only going to be on what? Al-raf'u. We're going to take al-raf'u with details, inshallah ta'ala. And this is important, my beloved brothers and sisters, that you try to understand this chapter, alamat al-i'rab. If you memorize the eight that I mentioned and how they enter each one of those four, that is the gist, that is the reality of what i'rab is. So we'll start inshallah ta'ala, we will start with al-raf'u. Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, he says, wa aqulu تستطيع أن تعرف أن الكلمة مرفوعة بوجود علامة في آخرها من أربع علامات، واحدة منها أصلية وهي الضمة، وثلاثة فروع عنها وهي الواو والألف والنون. He says, you can know if a word is مرفوع by one of the signs being present at the ending of it. And he mentioned that there are four. One, وَاحِدَةٌ مِنْهَا أَصْلِيَّةٌ. One of those four is asl, it's original. وَهِيَ الضَّمَّةُ. And that's only الضَّمَّةُ. وَثَلَاثَةٌ فُرُوعٌ عَنْهَا. And the other three are sub-branches of it. Meaning they come out from what? Al-Dhamma. Dhamma is Asl. And the reason why you need to know the difference between Asliya and Far'iya is that a person has the right to ask you, why is it marfu'un bilwawi? Or why is it marfu'un bil-alifi? Or why is it marfu'un minuni? Because it's a Far'a. But no one can ask you the Asl, the default position. You don't need to explain yourself. When something is upon the asal, you don't need to give it a justification for it. But if something diverts from the asal, the person has the right to say to you, لِمَا رُفِعَ why is it مَرْفُوعٌ بِالْأَلِفِ. And you need to explain your reason. Now we're going to study each one. Remember the eight that we took? Which of those four do they enter? Do they enter الرَّضَمُ الْوَاوُ الْأَلِفُ النُّونُ? From those four, which one does each of these eight enter? So inshallah ta'ala, I've written on the board. I'm going to give examples inshallah ta'ala بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ. Ponder here, we wrote on the board as a diagram. So الرَّفْعُ عَلَامَ أَصْلِيَّةِ, as the author said رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ. عَلَامَ أَصْلِيَّةِ here means original sign. So عَلَامَ أَصْلِيَةِ is original. And I said the original, from the eight, four of them enter here. Four of the eight, they are marfu'un bil-dhammah. And we'll take each one example, a proper example of it. Are we all together? Let's start with al-ism al-mufrad. Let's start with al-ism al-mufrad. So here we have ja'a. محمد. So if somebody asked you, جاء is a what? What verb is this? It's a past tense verb. جاء is a what? It's a past tense. It's a past tense verb. فعل ماضي. محمد is what? Muhammad is the one who's doing the coming. Muhammad came. So here this is called what? Fa'il. So Muhammad is a fa'il. Are we all together? And al-fata is what? We just need to know it's ma'atuf. We don't need to know what ma'atuf is. Are we all together? Which is that it's connected to Muhammad. But our focus point is Muhammad. Are we all together? Every fa'il that you see, you're always going to have to know that it's raf', it's marfu'. Every fa'il is marfu'. Every mubtada is marfu'. Every khabar is marfu'. And we're going to take the list, inshallah ta'ala, at the ending of the book. Fa'il is always what? Fa'il is always what? Fa'il is always marfu'. But it depends on what that thing is. If that thing in there is a ism mufrad, it takes the alama in what way? So now when you grammatically analyze it, you say, Ja'a, he came. Muhammadun, Muhammad came. We know Muhammad has to be what? Marfu'. Because it's a fa'il, it's a subject. I already know that. Then I ask myself, from the eight, which one is Muhammad? Is he ism mufrad? Is he jam'u al-taksir? Is he jam'u al-mu'annath salim? Is it fi'l al-mudari' alladhi lam yattasil bi-akhirihi shay? Is it a muthanna? Is it jam'u al-mudhakkar salim? Is it asma'u al-khamsa? Or is it af'al al-khamsa? I now know that Muhammad is one single individual. Sah? Now that I know Muhammad is singular, ism mufrad, a singular noun, the question here is, a singular noun, how does it express, how does it show the rafa? It shows it with a dhamma. So now what do I say? I say fa'il marfu'un with what? That's it. Fa'ilun marfu'un with dhamma. It's a fa'il and it's marfu' with what? With dhamma. Are we all together? Wal-fata is what? والفتى مرفوع وعلامة رفعه ضمة منع من ظهورها. What prevented it from showing is what? التعذر, because we took the alif over there, right? It won't show. فتى is also مرفوع بالضمة, لكن منع من ظهورها. What's preventing from the ضمة showing like it shows on Muhammad is what? التعذر. And we took that before, that if it finishes with an alif is what? We took it before, that if it finishes with an alif, is mana'a min dhuhuriha at-ta'adhur. Very good. Does that make sense? Let's move on to the next one, which is jam'u at-taksir. Jam'u? Jam'u at-taksir. So let's see, look at what Sheikh Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid says. He said, مَوَاضِعُ الضَّمَّةِ قَالَ فَأَمَّا الضَّمَّةُ فَتَكُونُ عَلَامَةً لِلرَّفْعِ فِي أَرْبَعَةِ مَوَاضِعَ الْإِسْمُ الْمُفْرَدِ وَجَمْعُ التَّكْسِيرِ وَجَمْعِ الْمُؤَنَّثِ السَّالِمِ وَالْفِعْلِ الْمُضَارِعِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّصِلْ بِآخِرِهِ شَيْءٌ. وَأَقُولُ, I say, تَكُونُ الضَّمَّةُ, the dhamma comes and it happens and it's found, عَلَامَةً عَلَى رَفْعِ الْكَلِمَةِ فِي أَرْبَعَةِ مَوَاضِعَ, that it's found. تَكُونُ ضَمَّةُ, the dhamma is a sign for the raf' in four places. الموضع الأول, the first place is الاسم المفرد, and that's the one we just took. والموضع الثاني, the second place is جمع التكسير. والموضع الثالث, the third place is what? جمع المؤنث السالم. والموضع الرابع, الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره, الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل به ألف اثنين ولا واو الجماعة ولا ياء مخاطبة ولا نون توكيد خفيفة أو ثقيلة ولا نون نسوة. None of those are connected to it. So you mentioned three things that are connected to it. We'll come to that inshallah in details. So the first one he said that doesn't connect to it is what? It's not أفعال الخمسة. ألف الاثنين واو الجماعة ياء المؤنثة المخاطبة, that's أفعال الخمسة. It can't be it, number one. Number two is ألا يتصل بها, I can't connect to it is what? نون التوكيد. Whether that نون التوكيد is what? خفيفة أو ثقيلة. Doesn't matter. That's second. Three is نون النسوة. If the last two that I mentioned, نون التوكيد خفيفة, whether it's خفيفة أو ثقيلة, it becomes مبني. If نون النسوة connects to it, it becomes what? مبني. But don't worry, we're coming to that now. أما الاسم المفرد, we're taking اسم المفرد now. فالمراد به ها هنا ما ليس مثنى ولا مجموعا ولا ملحقا بهما ولا من الأسماء الخمسة, سواء كان المراد به مذكرا مثل محمد وعلي وحمزة, أم كان المراد به مؤنثا مثل فاطمة وعائشة وزينب, وسواء أكانت الضمة ضمة ظاهرة كما في نحو حضر محمد. So we took the definition before, ما ليس مثنى ولا مجموعا ولا ملحقا بهما. We already took that before. But he gives an example here that he says it can be مذكر, such as what? Muhammad and Ali and Hamza. Hamza is مذكر. Why? Because it's the meaning of مذكر. That's what's intended by it. أم كان المراد به مؤنثا, or the intent here is what? مؤنث, such as فاطمة and عائشة and زينب. As oh, سواء كانت الضمة ظاهرة, or the ضمة is present, it doesn't matter. All of it is مفرد, اسم مفرد. It gives you example. He says حضر محمد, حضر فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح لا محل له من الإعراب. محمد فاعل حضر, the فاعل of حضر, مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة, ضمة it's. وسافرت فاطمة, فاطمة traveled. وسافرت فاطمة, فاطمة traveled. سافرت is what? فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح لا محل له من الإعراب. The ta just shows تأنيث. فاطمة is what? فاعل سافر, أما سافرت, she's the فاعل of it. Good. مرفوع وعلامة رفعها is what? الضمة. أم كانت مقدرة, or whether it's implicit, it doesn't show. ظاهرة is when it shows. Those were the examples of a ظاهر. When it's implicit is حضر الفتى والقاضي وآخي. حضر is what? فعل ماضي مبني على الفتى لا محل له من العربي. الفتى is what? It's what? فاعل. الفتى is فاعل here. حضر الفتى. حضر means come, came. الفتى, the فتى came. So who's doing the coming here? Who's the subject? Who's the one that's doing the coming? الفتى, the boy is. فتى means boy. So he is مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة. منع من ظهورها التعذر. هي والقاضي, قاضي was, what's its reason? مرفوع, ايه, it's معطوف. And it is what? مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة. منع من ظهورها. Good. It's good. والقاضي, okay. What do you call it? والقاضي, and we have وأخي. And the same with أخي, it is أخي is المناسبة, right? We have all of that. تزوجت ليلى ونعمة فإن محمد وإن كذا, and all of that. Now we're going to go to جمع التكسير. Now we're going to go to what? جمع التكسير. فالمراد به ما دل على أكثر من اثنين أو اثنتين مع التغير في صياغة مفرده. We don't need to do that. We spoke about that before. We just need an example. The author's example that he brought is what? The example is that the author رحمه الله brought is قام الرجال. قام الرجال. The men stood. قام الرجال. قام قام الرجال قام الرجال قام الرجال هي قام is what past tense verb okay الرجال is what it's the subject is the فاعل of قام the one that's doing the standing okay رجال here it's فاعل so we have already if it's فاعل what do we say فاعل مرفوع because فاعل we always know it's مرفوع so say فاعل and we say it's what مرفوع okay now we have to ask ourselves a question رجال from the eight that we mentioned which of them is it yeah is جمع التكسير right the broken plural How does the broken plural express itself with the rafa? So you say marfu'un? Marfu'un? Bid-dhamma. So you say marfu'un? Bid-dhamma. It is marfu'un bid-dhamma. Hey, what's the grammatical analysis of Abdul Ahad? Hadar al-hukam. هيا 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 فاعل مرفوع بالضمة صح which one of those is جمع تكسير good ما شاء الله سعد حضر الحكام والأسارة هيا what's أسارة أما أسارة تبين To be precise. Usara. What's the word usara? What is it? Grammatically analyze it. Hey. Hey. Yeah, usara. هيا هيا التعذر نعم منع من ظهورها التعذر very good أسارة is the جمع of أسير captive yeah is جمع أسرى is a plural أسارة is the جمع of the جمع again we'll go together أسير is a captive أسرى Captives. Osara is captive. You're making it even more of a jama. So this is called what? It's called jam'ul jama. Very good. Hey, what's the third one that the author mentioned? Jam'ul mu'annath salim. Jam'ul mu'annath salim. What did we say it was? Ma jumi'a bi alifin wa ta'in mazidatayn. ما جمع بألف وتاء مزيدتين. It's anything that any word that ends with an alif and ta at the ending, or an alif and ta and ending is being added to the wording. Such as جاءت الفاطمات جاءت الفاطمات الفاطمات. What did Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid choose? What example did he bring? So what we say is جاءت الفاطمات. He mentioned here, he says ما دل على أكثر من اثنين بزيادة ألف وتاء في آخره نحو زينبات وفاطمات وحمامات تقول جاء الزينبات وسافر الفاطمات. So you can, you say وسافرت الفاطمات فاطمات, you can say it. Or if you want, you can choose not to. You'll have the rights. Okay, جاءت الفاطمات. فاطمات came. فاطمات here is what? Again, the word جاءت. So we have جاء الفا جاء جاءت الفاطمات صح جاءت الفاطمات فاطمات have come. جاءت is what? It's فعل ماضي. Past tense verb. فاطمات is what? What is it? فاعله. Automatically we say فاعل is always what? And what is it مرفوع here with? It's مرفوع بالضمة. Right? Why do we say it's مرفوع بالضمة? Because جمع المؤنث سالم is in this category. And فاطمات is what? Are we all together? And al-Fatimat is what? Fatimat is here in this category. And it's Dhamma. So anything in this category is always going to be marfu'un bil Dhamma. Any of those four. Are we all together? Very good. We're now going to do the last one of Dhamma, which is الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. صح؟ The author says, وأما فعل المضارع فنحو يضرب يكتب فكل من هذين الفعلين مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الضمة ظاهرة وكذلك يدعو ويرجو. Here he says, as for the فعل المضارع, it is such as يضرب يكتب. يضرب and يكتب are both what? What is يضرب and يكتب? The فعل مضارع. How do you know it's a فعل مضارع? How do you know it's a فعل مضارع? Because now, how do you know this word is فعل مضارع? Why do you say فعل ماضي وفعل أمر? Yes, so the زوائد الأربعة is there. The ياء is in front of it. So we say يضرب. يضرب. صح? يضرب is what? Is مرفوع بالضمة. That's the أصل of the فعل مضارع. That's the default position of the فعل مضارع. I will together. فعل مضارع, wherever you see it originally, is that it is marfu'un bil-dhamma. That's the asal. There's only twice when it can move away from that position. And that is when adawatul nasbi or adawatul jazmi enter it. Are we all together? There are words we're going to learn. If they go before it, they make it mansub. If they go before it, they make it what? Majzoom. Are we all together? Because there's nothing before it now, it is marfu'un with what? That's why they say marfu'un bil-dhammati li-tajarrudihi, because it's stripped from. I mean, it's not before it. What's not before it? Adawat which are nasb or adawat which are jazm. None of them are going before it. So in that situation, the default position of a fi'l mudari', wherever you see it, as long as you don't see those words go before it, it is marfu'un bil-dhamma. You just need to know that. Does that make sense? Are we all together? We're going to learn, inshallah ta'ala, what those things that are, if they enter it, they make it mansub, and what if they enter it when they make it majzum. We're going to take that in when we come to the nasb and the jazm, inshaAllah ta'ala. But here the Shaykh says, rahimahullah, he says, وَأَمَّا فِعْلُ الْمُضَارِعِ. We know what فِعْلُ الْمُضَارِعِ is. So يَدْعُ is a فِعْلُ الْمُضَارِعِ. اسم فِعْلُ الْمُضَارِعِ. يَرْجُو. Yeah. يَدْعُو and يَرْجُو is a فِعْلُ الْمُضَارِعِ. Hey, what's the إعراب of يَرْجُو, hey? Yeah. هي فعل مضارع مرفوع هي. It's not showing though. يضرب, you can see it. You see, you can see it right there. I'm saying it to you. But يدعو and يرجو, you can't see it. What's happened? Yeah. هي منع من ظهورها. What is preventing it from showing? Yeah? Al-thiqal, yes, heavy. يرجو أن يدعو is heavy. You have in the Quran, Allah say, لَن نَدْعُوَ. Allah placed an alama on it. Allah placed alama on it. So it does, it can show. But it's thiqal. يرجو is also thiqal. You could say if you wanted to. يقضي and يرضي, both of them are what? يا عمران. يقضي. What type of verb is that? هيا. ومرفوع بدوا. هيا. Why is it not showing? When you say munasaba, ya akhi Imran, you have to realize that the word can stand by itself without this word. Munasaba means when you're attributing this person to yourself. Are you with me? And that's not the case right now. So what is it? Thiqal, heaviness. Good. What about yarda? Wa yaqwa? Is it marfu'a, hey? Yarda and yaqwa, hey? And yaqwa, hey? هي فعل مضارع, فعل مضارع مرفوع بالضمة منع من ظهورها التعذر, because it's alif, right? Good, جميل, very good. When the author said الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء, what does that mean when we say فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء? It means three things are not connected to it. Three things, right? Three things don't connect to it. Number one is nunu. It's not amthilatul khamsa. We call it amthilatul khamsa for a reason. We're going to come to that, inshallah ta'ala. And if it's amthilatul khamsa, aliful ithnaini, wawul jama'a, or ya al mu'annathat al mukhataba, doesn't enter it. That's the first. As long as it doesn't turn into af'alul khamsa. But we're calling it amthilatul khamsa because that's correct. Are we all together? Number two. Point number two. Noon al-Tawkeed doesn't enter it. And I said Noon al-Tawkeed, it can be khafif or thaqila, whichever it comes from. Are we all together? Which is yadhhabanna. Sah? Is that right? Or is that Noon al-Niswa? Huh? What's the difference between Noon al-Tawkeed and Noon al-Niswa? And the third one, let me just say Noon al-Niswa. Noon al-Niswa. I'm a Noon al-Inatha, some call it. Hey, what's the difference between Noon al-Tawkeed and Noon al-Niswa? What's the difference between the two? Yeah? What about Noon al-Niswa? Doesn't have shadda on it? Noon al-Niswa doesn't have shadda on it? That's wrong. Hey, Fadl, next, who knows the answer? Ha. Huh. Yeah, Noon al-Tawkeed and Noon al-Niswa, how do we distinguish between the two? What's the distinguishing fact? It's nothing to do with the issue of the Shadda. That's not the factor that they distinguish it with.